So let us see the further part, that is the determination of the probable errors. Already you have seen these five cases. For fifth case is very much important here, that is the probable error of the computed quantities may be calculated by applying the laws of the weights. Now for this laws of the weight, okay. So you have to note down all these equations. Once again, I am appealing to all the students, you note down all these equations with this conditions equation, and this part is very much important in case of your the examinations. Because of that, the most of the MCQs are to be set on this computed quantities. So let us see the further part. We'll take one more example so that you can understand it, and simultaneously you note down these observations. Take the table. Observed values of an angle are given below. Please note down angle 85 degree, 20 minutes, 40 minutes, 20 seconds, three angles, and it has assigned the weight. It has a different weight. For first quantity, assign the weight 2. Second quantity is assigned the weight 2. Third quantity is assigned the weight 3, and find the probable error of single observation value of the unit weight. Second, you find out the probable error of the weight arithmetic mean method and probable error of the single observations of weight 3 now here. So let us note down this example. Then we'll go for the next. So while taking these values, weight is going to be assigned 2, 2, 3. Number of observations are the 3 observations, and you know this is the common angle 85 degree, 40 minutes, 40 minutes. This 20 second, 18 second, and 90 second. It has the different values in terms of the seconds. Only noted here. And n is equal to the 3, that is now the error for calculation of the error. And weight is assigned for the first quantity, that is now the 2, 2, 3. This is column number 2. Then value into multiplied by the weight. So your value is nothing but 20 seconds multiplied by the 2. So this 20 seconds multiplied by the 2, it becomes the 40 seconds. In some of the cases, you have taken the whole angle multiplied by the 2. Suppose earlier angle it was now 85 degree, 40 minutes, 20 seconds multiplied by the 2, find out this value, or you have to multiply by the 2, but the effects are same. This is the same value, that's why only considering the 20 seconds, 18 seconds and the 19 seconds. Please kindly note it, and during examination, if the angle is given like that, so for the same station you are observing the different angles, and 3 observers are there for the same station, and this is the error is going to be occupied with the observers, and how to rectify those errors. But it has assigned the weights. For first observer, the weight is assigned 2. Second observer, weight is assigned 2. For third observer, weight is assigned 3. So summation of the weight is 7, that is 2, 2 plus 3. And the value into the weight is also required to find out, that is 40 seconds, 30 seconds, 50 seconds. Then summation of this, that is 133 seconds divided by the 7. So it is nothing but that is 19 now here, 19 seconds. Then why you have taken the 7? Because of that, this is the weight is assigned to this quantity. 2 plus 2 plus 3, it is nothing but 4 plus, that is 7. Adding all the angles, A, that is the first observation, that is the value into the weight, that is angle into the weight, that is 40 seconds plus 30 seconds plus 50 seconds divided by 2 plus 2 plus 3 now here. So this is equally distributed, that is now the 19 seconds. Next parameter, that is about the variance. Find out this plus 1, minus 1 and the 0 as per the calculation. You know the formula. V square, you find out this 1, 1, 0 according to the formula. Then W into the V square, find out this value, W into the V square. So that is 2 into V square 1, 2 into 1, 2, 2 and this is now the 0. Find out summation of the W square. Then next step, we will go for the solutions. Probable error of the single observation of unit weight. So that is now plus or minus 0.6745 root of summation of W square by n minus 1. Substituting this value, already you have to find out. Then find out this probable error with the single observation of unit weight. Then probable error of the weighted arithmetic mean. If you apply the weight, then this is the formula you applied over there. And find out this error, that is now plus or minus 0.36 seconds. And probable error of the single observation of weight 3. If you apply the weight 3, so taken root of the W, and which is now root of 3, that is now the 0.548 seconds. So the fourth part is also remaining, that is for the most probable values, and you can be find out this finding those errors. Then very important part, please note down and give the highlight, laws of the weights. Please note down this, laws of the weight. So all of you write this in your regular notebook. What do you mean by the laws of weights? So first of all, you understand the term. What do you mean by the weight? So weight of a quantity is nothing but it's a trustworthiness or real value of a quantity, realistic values. Then relative precision and trustworthiness of an observation as compared to the precision of the other quantity is known as the weight of the observation. Let us note down the definition and meaning of the weight of the observations. So the weight of the quantity is nothing but it's a real value, it's a correct value, or the value is reaches to the corrected value, approaches to the real value. That is nothing but the trustworthiness of a quantity. And what do you mean by the weight of an observation? Weight of an observation is nothing but the relative position and trustworthiness of an observation as compared to the precision of the other quantities is known as the weight of an observation. Weights are always expressed in terms of the numbers. It may be the 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this. Second part, there are the different laws of the weights, 7 laws. So 7 laws you applied for these laws of the weights. So first of all, higher number indicates the higher precision values. Please understand this and trust as compared to the lesser number. So the laws of weight 1, laws of weight 2, laws of weight 3, there are the 7 laws. So 7 laws, how it is to be applied, see on the next slide. So the laws of the weight 1 is nothing but the weight of the arithmetic mean of a number of observation of unit weight is equal to the number of observation. Please remember, the weight of arithmetic mean of number of observation of unit weight, not different weight, of unit weight is equal to the number of the observation. So its value, if you have taken the arithmetic mean value of all the observations, but it has the unit weight, then which is now equal to the number of the observation. That is now the law number one, that is law of weight number one. Second law, or see the examples for the laws number weight one. So you have, these are the observations, 65 degree this second. So the angle you measured the same, but observers are different. Then you have to get the correct value of this angle A. So how to find out if the unit weight is applied for each angle according to the first law? So calculate the weight of the arithmetic mean of the following observation of an angle of the unit weight calculated. See here. So please let us note down. There are the three observers, three observations, but it has the unit weight. Arithmetic mean, suppose observer A reads this angle, observer B, observer C, but the station point is same, divided by this 3, and which is now equal to this 65 degree, 30 minutes and the 15 seconds. But the weight, according to the law weight, law 1, so this value must be equal to the number of observations. So therefore, the weight of the arithmetic mean is equal to the n, and which is now equal to the 3. And your answer according to laws of weight 1 is weight of arithmetic mean 65 degree, 30 minutes 15 second is now 3. So the weight of this arithmetic mean value of unit weight is equal to the number of observation. How many number of the observation? That is now 3. Therefore, you taken as the weight of this arithmetic mean value is 3 number. I think you understand this first law. Then second law, please note down, law second, the weight of the weighted, it's not only the simple arithmetic mean, but it is the weighted arithmetic mean. So it has weighted value. So means weight you need to apply for each observation. So in earlier case, laws of the weight one, only the unit weight is assigned. But in the second law, you have to assign the different weights. So suppose the weighted key to take down, then the weight of such observations should be equal to, that means the weighted arithmetic mean of number of observation is equal to the sum of the individual weights of the observation. Please remember, suppose we have assigned the different weights, W1, W2, W3 like that. So the sum of the individual weights, weight is assigned with the numerical value 2, 3, 4 like that. Then you add all the weights now here for this weighted arithmetic value, for this weighted observed value. So how it is? Let us see the example. Suppose observer A, 40 degree. These are the angle observer observed values with the same angle, but the weight is assigned different. In earlier case, weight is assigned unit weight. So that's why we have taken 1, 1, 1. But the how to get the weight value, how to find out the weight of these arithmetic weighted values. So let us see, weight is 1, 2 and the 3. How to find out what is the weight of this weighted arithmetic mean of this angle, how it is calculated. Let us see. That means the 40 degree multiplied by the its weight, it is now 1. For second observed value, that is weight 2. And third observed value is the 3, divided by the summation of all this weight, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3. And that is now equal to the weighted arithmetic mean value, is the 40 degree 15 minutes 12.33 seconds. So you please remember and understand this. So the 40 degree 15 minutes 10 seconds multiplied by 1. 40 degree 15 minutes 14 seconds multiplied by 2 plus 40 degree 15 minutes 12 seconds multiplied by 3, divided by this 1 plus 2 plus 3 now here. And find out this error. That is now the, what would be the correct angle? That is a 40 degree 15 minutes. But how much its weight? Then individual weight is 1 plus 2 plus 3, which is now equal to the 6. Then what it indicates? So the weighted arithmetic mean values according to the laws 2, weight of the weighted arithmetic mean of the angle, which is now equal to the sum of the individual weights. So therefore, the weighted arithmetic mean value of this 40 degree 15 minute 12.33 seconds has the weight of the 6. You are adding all the individual weights according to the laws 2. Then let us see the next law, that is laws of the weight. That is the weight of arithmetic sum, or the either you take the addition or either you take the subtraction. Sum of the two or the more quantities is equal to the reciprocal of the sum of the reciprocal of the individual weights. Let us note down laws number 3. This is under the laws of the weights. Weight of the arithmetic sum of the two or more quantities is equal to the reciprocal of the sum of the reciprocals of the individual weights. How it is to be there? Let us see. So calculate the weights of A plus B, addition or it may be the subtractions. You have the observed value of A, observed value of the B, but it has assigned the individual weights. Observed value of the A, it is an angle with the weight of 3. Observed value of the B, how this is angle and the weight 4, this is a weighted angle, and you need to find out the summation A plus B, how it would be, or you take the subtraction, how it would be, then what would be its corresponding value, that is applied for the weight 3. Then according to this example, so the A plus B is nothing but simply you add this angle, that is now 71 degree 30 minutes 50 seconds. Then A minus B, subtraction, while subtraction, this angle minus this angle, that is now this one. Then according to the law 3, so you have to assign the weight in terms of its reciprocal value. Therefore, 1 by 1 by W1 plus 1 by W2. So for A value, it has the weight of 3. Then W2, it has the weight of 4. Taking this reciprocal of the 1 by 3 plus 1 by. So reciprocal of the assigned weight. So please remember, what is that law? See the statement of this law 3. Reciprocal of this assigned weight. Now here, that means the 1 by this value, but you have taken this reciprocal of this weight values, that is 1 by W1, and that is now 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4, which is now equal to 12 by 7. Therefore, so the summation of this angle A plus B is equal to, you take this value summation, 17.1 degree, 30 minutes, 50 seconds, but weight is 12.7. Means either it may be the subtraction, either it may be the addition, weight is going to be assigned and calculated with this formula. So this is as per the laws number 3. Then let us see the next law, laws of the weight 4. So what about this? We have taken the product of any, for example, A into B. How to find out? If it has assigned the weight, then how to find out its the value? So therefore, the weight of the product, let us note down this statement, weight of the product of any quantity multiplied by a constant value, any constant, is equal to the weight of that quantity, is equal to the weight of that quantity divided by the square of that constant. So please remember, so weight of the product of any quantity multiplied by the constant values is equal to the, how to find out its weight? It is equal to the weight of that quantity divided by the square of that constant. So let us see. Suppose the, what is the weight of 3A? Suppose 3 is multiplying parameter. Angle A is given, 30 degree, 25 minutes, 40 seconds. Its weight is 3. Then you need to find out the 3 times of the A, 3A value. So the solution is there according to this law. 3A and its entire weight is weight, assigned weight divided by the square of this coefficient. That means this 3 is the coefficient, constant value. You take this square of this value. So weight of 3A multiplied by this 3 into this angle A, which is now 91 degrees, 17 minutes and 00 seconds. How much this weights, which is now equal to W by C square. W is the, already the weight is 3, and divided by this C square, that means the constant, that is now 3 square. So 3 by 9, it becomes the 1 by 3 is the answer. Then let us see the laws of the weight 5. If the weight of quotient of any quantity divided by a constant is equal to this weight of that quantity multiplied by the square of that value down here. So according to the laws 5, compute the weight of this A by 4. See, and of weight 3. So angle A is 36 degree, 20 minutes, 40 seconds. And the constant is a division, that means the dividation. In earlier case, you take the product. Here you take the dividations. So the dividation, that is the division, is of the 4, weight W. Then observed value is the N, that is a 3, that is weight 3. According to the laws for you, so weight should be assigned, that is A by 4, which is now equal to the product. In earlier case, you have taken the dividation W by C square for product. But for the dividation, you take the W into C square. So find out the weight of A by 4. Angle A is divided by 4. Find out this angle, which is now equal to the W. W is the weight, is a 3. Into this C value, is the coefficient, is a 4. You take the square value of this coefficient. That is now 4 square. Therefore, A by 4 is 9 degree, 5 minutes, 10 seconds. And its weight is 4 degrees, nothing but 16 into 3. That is now the 48 now. Then let us see the next one, that is laws of the weight 6. Weight of the quotient remains if all the signs of the equations are changed, or if the equation is added or to be subtracted. So let us remember, weight of the quotient remains the unchanged. When it is remains unchanged or constant, if all the signs of the equations are changed, or if the equation is added or subtracted, then none of the changes is going to be observed in the weight of the observation. For example, A plus B is equal to this angle. It has the weight of 3. So what is the weight if you are changing the sign? Minus of the A plus B, which is now equal to this 180 degree minus of the A plus B. Then there is no change in the weight. Therefore, according to the laws, if you have taken the minus of this A plus B, will remain the same. Therefore, this angle must be U. Only you take the sine value minus 76 degree, but weight is 3. And weight of this 180 degree, if you need to find out this 180 degree minus A plus B, then the particular weight remains the same. There is no change in the corresponding value. Either you are adding or either you are changing the sign. That is now the laws of weight number 6. Then what about the laws of the weight number 7? If an equation is multiplied by its own weight, see, if any equation is multiplied by its own weight, the weight of the resulting equation is equal to the reciprocal of that weight of that equation. Let us note down this statement. If any equation is multiplied by its own weight, either it may be the 2, 3 like that, different weights, the weight of the resulting equation is equal to the reciprocal of the weight of that equations. Therefore, see the example. Calculate the weight of this equation 3 by 4 of A plus B. If the weight of the A plus B is 3 by 4, then observed value A plus B is 120 degree, 20 minutes and the 40 seconds. Then apply the law. As per the equation, multiplied by its weight, own weight is given here. That is now this 3 by 4. So the 3 by 4 into the A plus B. So the 3 by 4, we have to multiply by this A plus B. A plus B value is given 180 degree into 20 minutes, 40 seconds into the 3 by 4. Find out this angle 90 degree, 15 minutes, 30 seconds. But what would be its weight? It is now equal to the reciprocal of this weight now here. So therefore, so the 1 by 3, 4, weight is assigned 3 by 4. You have to take on the reciprocal of the particular weight. Here you multiplied by this weight, that is whatever the weight, so which is now equal to 1 by the 3 by 4 value, that is now 4 by 3 according to the laws of the weight number 7 now here. So this is the way to compare all these values, and let us see the theory of the least square next part. It's very important part about the least square. What do you mean by the theory of the least square? So the principle of this distributing error by the method of least square, I think you had applied this method of least square already. You are aware to the method of the least square is of the great help to find out the most probable value. The method of the least square is also applied for find out the most probable values of a quantity which has been measured for several times. So it is found from the probability equation that the most probable values of the series of errors arising from the observations of equal weight are those for which the sum of the squares is a minimum. Then fundamental laws of the least square is derived from this. Now here, see the fundamentals. So the fundamental laws you have to be applied for the method of the least square. So the fundamental principle of the method of the least square may be stated as, so all of you note down this method, that is a principle of the method of the least square. In observation of the equal precision, please note down, in observation of equal precision, the most probable value of the observed quantity are those that render the sum of the square of the residual error is a minimum. So please remember and understand this equation statement for the principle of the method of the least square. So always this same question shall be asked in oral examination. So in observation of equal precision, the most probable value of the observed quantities are those that render the sum of the square of the residual error is a minimum values. All of you note down this. Then let us see the next part. theory, if the measurements are of equal weight, the most probable value is that which makes the sum of the squares of the residual is minimum. So according to this principle of the least square, so method of the least square, summation of the v square should be how the minimum value. It is for equal weight, please remember, it is for equal weight. If the measurements are of unequal weight, if the measurements are of unequal weight, then the MPV, or called the most probable value, is that which makes the sum of the products of the weights and the square of the residuals is a minimum value. So the different weights are assigned. So you take the summation of W1, W2 like that, V1, V2 like that. So W1, V1 square plus W2, V2 square. You take the summation of all these values, it should be equal to the minimum value. So this is the law, this is the principle you have to be applied for equal weight and for the unequal weight. For equal weight, only taken summation of this V square, which is now equal to the minimum value. But for unequal weight, you take the product of this weight and the summation of this V square, which is now equal to the minimum values. So then next part, when a quantity is being deduced from a series of the observations, residual error will be the difference between the adopted value and the several observed values. Let us see the x1, x2, x4, these are the observed values. Z is the most probable values. Then how to get these values? Let us see. So the Z minus x1, Z is the most probable values, minus this is the x1 observed value, which is equal to e1. Z minus x2 is e2, Z minus x3 is e3, up to the last term, n number of term, Z minus of xn is equal to en. So where e's are the respective residual error of the observed values. Then next step, so according to the method of least square, arithmetic mean is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 up to the xn divided by the n. Find out this most probable values as per this rule. And let us note down this. All of you note down this. And let us see the further part. You are noted by taking only the arithmetic mean values. Next part. According to the equation number 1, you have to find out the n number of observations. Z is the most probable value minus the summation of x value, which is now equal to the summation of e. And Z most probable values for the arithmetic, as per the arithmetic mean method, which is now equal to summation of x by n plus summation of e by n. This is the probable error, but summation of x by n is equal to the m from equation 2, and you need to find out the most probable value, z is equal to m plus summation of e by n. So let us note down, this is equation number 3. If the number of observation is large, n is very large, e is kept small by making precise measurements, and the second term, summation of the e by n, becomes nearly equal to the zero value. Thus, z is equal to m value. So the number of observation is large, arithmetic is the true value or called the most probable value. So then we calculated the residual error. How to find out the residual error? V1, V2, like that. So the from the mean values. So the this is the most probable values minus the observed values, will get the residual errors. This is m minus x2, will get the v2. M minus x3 up to the n term, m minus xn is equal to vn. That way you find out the errors, that is the residual errors. Then adding this above, nm minus summation x, which is equal to summation of the v, m is equal to summation of x by n plus summation of v by n. M is nothing but summation x by n under the consideration if this value is 0. Hence, sum of the residual equal to the 0 and sum of the plus residuals equal to the sum of the minus residual. So, rules for giving weights and distribution of errors to the field observations, how it is applied on field. So, what type of the rules? Weights of an angle varies directly to the number of observations made on the angle. Weight, now while doing this project on most probable values, particularly for this quadrilateral project, you have to apply those weights. The weight of the level lines vary inversely as the lengths of their roots. Weight of any angle measured a large number of times is inversely proportional to the square of the probable errors. Please note down this. Then corrections to be applied to the various observed quantities are in inverse proportion to their weights now here. And the distribution of errors to the field observations, how it is to be distributed, those errors in the field observations. Whenever the observations are made in the field, there is always some error called the accidental error. It is always necessary to check the observations made in the field for closing the error, if any. Then sign of the correction is opposite to that of the closing error. Suppose we are completing the traverse and the error must be, while closing those error must be the zero. Because of that, you are reaching to the first station. So you have started the work with the first station and your work is ended with the first station and you are completing this traverse. So the closing error must be equal to, but it is doesn't happen now here. It has a certain error. Then how it is to be distributed if it is the weighted observations? So distribution of error to the field observation. Corrections to be applied to an observation is inversely proportional to the weight of the observation. In other words, greater the weight, the smaller the corrections. Corrections to be applied to an observation is directly proportional to the length of the probable error. Then distribution of the error to the field observation, in case of the line of the levels, the correction to be applied is proportional to the length of the root. If all the observations are of the same weight, error is distributed to the observed quantities equally and therefore the corrections are equal. Then examples of the distribution of error, let us see the example. So it's very important part, and please remember and give the more attentions while solving this problem. Following are the three angles. See, angle A is equal to 82 degree, 15 minute, 20 second, plus or minus, this is the error, 2 seconds. Over the station O, and you are closing the horizon, along with their probable errors of these measurements, determine the corrected values, determine their corrected values, how it is to be corrected. So it's a point of interesting example, and you can understand all the concepts, how it is to be applied. Then sum of this angle may be the 359 degree, 59 minutes and the 45 seconds. But the discrepancy you are going to be observed while closing the traverse, your summation of all the angles must be equal to 360 degrees. If not, then it has the error. you were observed that is summation of all the angle is equal to 359 degree 59 minute and 45 seconds means it has the error of the 15 seconds. So there is a need to add those errors. So each angle is to be increased. Hence error is of the 15 seconds is to be distributed in equal proportional to the square of the probable error. So how it is to be distributed? Let us see. So therefore, C1, C2 be the corrections for each angle. For angle A, correction C1, angle B, C2, angle C is the C3. How to distribute this error in equal proportional? That is C1 is proportional to the C2, C2 is proportional to the C3. So it means to that, this is the error in the angle A, 2 square plus 4 square plus 3 square, which is now equal to 4 as to 16 as to 9 now here. Therefore, if you are adding this correction must be equal to the 15 seconds. Therefore, how to apply those corrections? This proportionate will be equal to this. That is the 4 as to 6, 16 as to 9 now here. So the C2 must be equal to, how to get the C2? Or you take the C1 by C2 is equal to C2 by C3. C1 by C2 is nothing but that is the now the 4 by 16. So similarly, according to the equation number 1, C2 is nothing but 16 by 4 into the C1. C2 can be worked out, which is now equal to 4 times of the C1. There similarly, you have to find out means the corrections for the angle B is 4 times of the C1. First of all, find out the corrections at the angle A. And C3 may be equal to, as per the equation number 1, C3 may be equal to the 9 by 4 of the C1. You are equating with respect to the C1 value. So substituting these values of the C2 and the C3 in equation 2, this is equation 2, because of that the addition of all the corrections should be equal to the 15 seconds. So the C1 plus 4, so C1 is equal to C1, you are considering C1. C2 is nothing but the, you are calculating 4 times of the C1 and the C3, you are finding in terms of the C1 term, that is 9 by 4 C1. Adding all these terms, which is now equal to the 15 seconds. So first step, you find out the C1 value. So by doing these calculations, you equate the values for the C1, and C1 is nothing but 2.077 seconds now here. Please remember. Then what is my C2 value? Corrections for the B angle, which is now 4 times of the C1. So the 4 into multiplied by this 2.07 seconds, that is now 8.28. And for C3, which is 9 by 4 C1, so 9 by 4 into this 2.07, that is now the 4.65. Then finally you take the check, C1 plus C2 plus C3 must be equal to 15 seconds. And that is now we'll have to check it. And then angle you need to be corrected. So the A is the 82 degree plus 15 minutes plus 20 seconds plus C1. You are adding this angle because of that error is negative. So therefore you have to add those angles. Add this 2.07 seconds. For B, how much? That is the correction 2 for B, which is now 8.28 seconds. Add this correction for C, that is now 4.65 seconds. Then find out those errors. That is now the 82 degree, 15 like this. And according to that, you must be calculate the corrected value of this angle. I think you are understanding this example. If you are understand this example, then there is no problem. There is no problem to solve the further examples. Then distribution of the error according to the weight. Let us see. That is adjustment of the following angles with the applied certain weights. Here is applied the weights, but with finding the errors with the equal weights. Then in the second example, we'll see if every angle is assigned the different weights, how it is to be solved. So angle A, let us note down, angle A, 112 degree, 20 minute, 47 seconds. It has assigned by the weight 2. Angle B, this value 90 degree, 30 minutes, 15 seconds. It has assigned weight 3. This is C and the D, that is, this example is related for the weighted observations and how to distribute those errors. I think you have noted this, then we'll go for the next. So the sum of the four angles, which is now 360 degree, 0 minutes and 8 seconds. So error is positive, need to subtract those errors. And discrepancy you have to be observed, that is a minus of 0.8 seconds. So these 8 seconds must be required to be subtracted from each angle. But it is possible only for the equal weighted observation. But this angle is measured with the weighted values. It has a certain weights. Therefore, each angle is to be decreased and error of this 8 seconds is to be distributed into the angle in an inverse proportionate to their weights. In earlier case, you are directly proportional to their weights. And definitely, we'll go for the next part. See the corrections. It is reciprocal. If it is weighted value, then you have to apply the correction in proportionate with their reciprocal values. C1 as proportional to the C2. C1 is correction for A, C2 is for B, C3 is for C, C4 is for D. Take this proportionate values, but it's reciprocal value of the weight, that is 1 by 2, 2 is weight is assigned for first angle, A, 3 is weight for B, 1 by 3, 1 is weight for C, and 4 is the weight for the angle D. So reciprocal of this observation. Therefore, C1 is proportional to the C2, C2 is proportional to the C3, C3 is proportional to the C4, So find out this value, 2 plus 3 plus 1, that means 5, 3, 8 plus 10, and taken this value. Therefore, you need to find out this is a 2 as proportional to the 4 by 3, as proportional to the 4, as proportional to the 1. You have taken the LCM as a 4. So for this first quantity, 2 parameters is required to multiply for the numerator, therefore 2. Here is again the getting the 4, that means reciprocal 4 by 3, it becomes the 3, that means the 1 value. Then for here is the 4 parameter is required, 4 as to 1. Therefore, if you are adding all these corrections, C1 plus C2, which is now equal to the 4 seconds. Therefore, comparing the results as per the previous methods, you take this ratio, C1 by C2 is nothing but 2 by 1 into the 3 by 4, which is now equal to the 6 by 4. Or C2, how to find out the C2? C2 is nothing but the 4 by 6 times of the C1 value. Therefore, C2 is equal to 2 by 3 C1 value. Similarly, C1 by C3 is 2 by 4. C3 you can be find out 2 times of the C1. So only equate these values. All these are the proportionate values. And for C4, again 1/2 the C1. So find out the corrections individually for each angle. C1, the first step is to find out the C1. Once you are getting the C1 values, then you can be find out the value of C2, then you can be find out the value of C3, you can be find out the value of the C4. So according to that, you substitute all these values. C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4 is equal to 4 seconds. Therefore, C1 plus C2 is now 2 by 3 C1. C3 is 2 times C1, C4 is 1/2 C1 is equal to 4 seconds. Therefore, C1 into that, take outside 1 plus 2, 3 is equal to 4 seconds. Solve this for C1 value, which is now equal to the 0.6. Find out C2, similarly find out the C3, then find out these correlations with these corrections, C4, 0.48, then hence to be corrected the angle, it is subtracted this angle. For angle A, minus of the C1, for angle minus of the C2, for angle C minus of the C3, for angle D is minus of the C4, and find out this corrected value. This is the way to be find out these corrections, how to find out the corrections directly with the help of the field observations. So the next part is the determination of the most probable values of the quantities. So let us know the meaning of the most probable values. So the most probable values, let us note down what do you mean by the most probable values. This is now the last term, and immediately we'll do it. The most probable values of a quantity is the value which has more chances of being true, correct value, than any other value, or this value is the closest value to the true value. So let us note down the most probable value, meaning of this. It can be determined from the principle of the least square. Systematic error are eliminated from the observation. Arithmetic mean will be the most probable values of the quantity being observed. So methods of the determination of the MP value. So let us note down, there are the three methods, major methods, methods of determination of the most probable values. First one is the Hello.